and Dr. İlker Türker. And you see the course book. This lecture notes from New Mexico Tech University. We are using this lecture note during our semester. So you should find and download it first. I am sharing the URL that you can download it. If you can look at the message box, you can see the URL, direct link to download it. If my voice and screen is clear, let's start. This will be an introduction lecture. Yes, an introduction lecture about what is probability and statistics, what are the basics of it, why do we learn it, how can we benefit in computer science, and so on. And this is chapter one, probability in the world around us. Yes, like mathematics, probability and statistics is also a basic and important course in all engineering fields, But for computer engineering, probability has more meaning, I think, because especially in artificial intelligence, in machine learning techniques, and some other programming issues, probability takes a role, very important role, and if you learn it good, you will be comfortable in your during your education. Yes, let's start. Probability in the world around us. This is chapter one. Probability theory is a tool to describe uncertainty. Yes, uncertainty. You know what is uncertainty? If an event is certain, you are sure that it will occur, its probability is simply one. We can say that an exact, a sure happening has probability as one. But if it is uncertain, or we are not sure about it, for example, tomorrow it will rain or not, we are not sure. For example, meteorologic predictions also say that there is a 40% of rain probability, and so on. Yes, so it describes uncertainty, and it has a value between, it takes a value between 0 and 1 for probabilistic events. In science and engineering, the world around us is described by mathematical models. You know some of them. Most mathematical models are deterministic. What does deterministic mean? Deterministic means that is the model output is supposed to be known uniquely, exactly. You can find the output exactly, yes, once all the inputs are specified. Yes, if you have the inputs, input parameters, you exactly calculate the output. An example is Newton's law, F equals to ma, I think you remember it, connecting the force F acting on an object of mass m, resulting in the acceleration a. Once F and m are specified, we can determine exactly the object's a acceleration. Yes, this is deterministic. And at the other end of the mathematical spectrum, there are some other phenomena that seem to completely escape any attempts at the rational description. That means we cannot rationally or exactly put the output. These are random phenomena, ranging from lotteries to heat-induced motion of the atoms, because if you induce the motion of atoms with heat, you cannot exactly guess the position of atoms. Or around the atoms, you know, nucleus, Electrons are turning and we cannot exactly determine the position of each electron, but we can guess it with a probabilistic measure. Upon closer consideration, there are still some laws governing this phenomena. However, they would not apply on case by case basis, but rather to results of many repetitions. That means, yes, for example, Michael Jordan has a probability of scoring a basket in a free throw is 0.8. We know that he has a probability of 0.8. How do we know it? From the past experience, from his past statistics, we know that his probability is 0.8. And next throw, on his next throw, can we exactly say that he will score? Can you say that he will score on his next throw exactly? No. It has a probability of 0.8. Yes, it is a high probability, but we cannot exactly say that he will score. But if he tries 10 times or 100 times, how many successful throws do you expect after 100 throws? Yes, very good. After 100 throws, you expect 80 scores, at least or not, at least approximately 80. For example, it may be 75 or a successful day, 85. But in average, we expect 80 basket scores from him on average. So, probabilistic approach works well on many repetitions. But you cannot exactly say he will score or not in the next trial. For example, we cannot predict the result of one particular lottery drawing, but we can calculate probabilities of certain outcomes, and so on. This is the stuff that probabilistic models are made of. Yes. And another example of field where probabilistic models are routinely used is actuarial science. Yes, actuarial science. Do you know what is actuarial? Did you hear about it, actuarial? Yes, a bit mathematics and insurance, human lifetimes, business science. Yes, all are correct. It deals with lifetimes of humans and tries to predict how long any given person is expected to live. Why? Because, for example, they will make insurance application for him or her, and they have to predict his or her lifetime. If you are retired, for example, you get money from the government until you are dead. So the government must predict how long you will live, and this prediction does not work well for one person, but works well for the community. For example, they expect on average 75 years of lifetime or 80 years of lifetime, and it works well from the past experience. They can extract how long human or human turkey lives, and this prediction works well for the community, but not for one person, because it may have deviations for only one person. Yes, of course, this expected lifespan is a poor prediction for any given person, but it works rather well when applied to many persons, it says. Today's science deals with enormously complex models. For example, the models of Earth's climate. Yes, there are too many expensive and very complex models. For example, last week, you know, there was a snowstorm in west cities of Turkey, especially west cities, but it affected some other cities also. Before, or 1 week before the happening, the climate models were giving this information to experts and also to us, certainly. Yes, there are many of these models available at different levels of complexity and resolution. But they are also not certain because they guess that Karabük will receive 20 or 30 centimeters of snow, but in reality, no, we didn't receive. But it was a prediction. But it worked well for Istanbul, for example. Yes, probability. What is probability? Probability theory is the branch of mathematics that studies the possible outcomes of given events together with the outcomes, relative likelihoods, and distributions. In common usage, the word probability is used to mean the chance that a particular event or set of events will occur expressed on a linear scale from zero, that means impossible, to one, that means certain. We can also express it with percentage from between 0 and 100%. The analysis of data possibly generated by probability models is called statistics. Yes, if you analyze the past data especially, it means you are using statistics. Yes. Another way to define probability. Yes. Is the ratio of the number of favorable outcomes, ratio of the number of favorable outcomes to the total number of all possible outcomes. Favorable outcomes means the outcomes you are involving in, you are focused on. For example, in this example, let's see it. Find the probability of getting a 3 or 5 when throwing a die. Yes, if you throw a die, the number of all possible outcomes is called, it is also called as the collection of all possible outcomes, is called as sample space. You will hear these words or snippets too many times during this semester. Sample space is the collection of all outcomes. So it is 6. In a dice experiment, it is 6. And what is the probability we are involving in getting a 3 or 5? So it is only 2 events that those are favorable. Favorable means point of interest here. We have only 2 outcomes over 6. So the result is 0.33. Yes, we will use a curved S for sample space, okay? Axioms of probability. All probability values are positive numbers, not greater than 1 and not less than 0. It cannot be negative, you know. An event that is not likely to occur or impossible has probability 0, while an event that is certain to occur has probability 1. For example, probability that a pregnant human being a female is 1, and probability that a human male being pregnant is 0. What is a random experiment? It is the process of observing the outcome of a chance event. For example, if you are throwing a die, what is die? You know what I, but I want to pass to my board now. Yes, if you are throwing a single die, you know it is called as die. But if you are rolling multiple dice, yes, it is dice. Yes, it is the white cube with black studs. Die. One die, two dice. Yes. If you throw, yes, if you roll this die, 100 times. Yes, if you roll this die 100 times, you are performing a what? Random experiment, okay? Yes. Outcome, the elementary outcomes of are all possible results of the random experiment. For example, you throw once, you get two, and then you get four, you get five, you get six, you get one. These are the outcomes of the experiment. And what is the sample space here? It is abbreviated with curved S. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And what about coins? What do you know about coins? For example, 1 Turkish lira. You know it. Yes, it has two sides. One side is head. The other side is tail. Now you are facing the tail side, okay? The other side is the head side. It is difficult to draw, you know. And you can also perform random experiment using a coin. And we use flipping the action of throwing a coin. We use the flip word simply. If you flip a coin once, your sample space is what? Head and tail. Okay? But if you flip twice, you may get two heads, head and tail, tail and head, and tail and tail. Okay? And if you throw three times, you can increase the sample space by what? What is the size of sample space if you roll, if you flip? Three times. What is the length of sample space? Yes, 2 to the power 3. We want to assign a numerical weight or probability to each outcome. We write the probability of AI as P of AI. For example, in our coin toss experiment, we may assign the probability of head equals to probability of tail. Probability of head equals to probability of tail. equals to 0.5. Yes. Revenue offset notation. What is complement? The complement of event A is the set of all outcomes in a sample that are not included in the event A. The complement of event A is denoted by A over. Yes. If the probability that an event occurs is P, then the probability that event does not occur is usually often called as Q, and Q is the complement of P, okay? Q equals to 1 minus P. That means P plus Q equals to 1. On the other words, Q equals to P complement, okay? And PA complement is 1 minus PA. Find the probability of not getting a 3 or 5. You know, we had calculated getting, probability of getting a 3 or 5. It was 2 over 6. Probability of not getting is the complement of it. So it is 4 over 6. As you see here. Is it okay? Yes, an intersection of events. I think all of you know about what is intersection and what is union by the means of sets. But in probability, it may have a bit different understanding. So be careful, okay? Listen carefully. The event A intersection B is the intersection of events A and B and consists of the outcomes that are contained within both events A and B. The probability of this event is the probability that both events A and B occur, but not necessarily at the same time. We will abbreviate intersection as AB. A intersection B equals to A, okay? Exclusive events means they have no intersection. Yes, as you see here, you know, they have no intersection. Here, they have an intersection and it is called as AB. If this is A, this is B. Their intersection is AB. But if they have no intersection, they are mutually exclusive events. They have ampli intersection. They have no outcomes in common. And another expression is union. Union is also important for us. It also needs care about it. The event A union B is the union of events A and B. A union B, you know it. Then it consists of the outcomes that are contained. Yes, be careful. That are contained within at least one of the events A and B. A, only A, only B or A intersection B is the subsets of union. Yes, and the probability of this event PA union B is the probability that at least one of them occurs. Don't forget at least, okay? At least one, pardon. At least one of them occurs. Yes, it is shown with this diagram. And I think you are familiar with Venn diagram. In a Venn diagram, if this is set A, this is set B, you know the intersection is AB, and this side is AB complement. Why? Because what is B complement? B complement is outside B. Outside B. And intersect it with A. What is the intersection with A? This is the intersection of B complement with A. So this area is AB complement. Okay. So similarly, this means only A. Only A area. Okay. And this is only B area. Only B means B A complement or A complement B. And outside area of AB is the intersection of A complement and B complement. Okay? And the outside bounding box is the sample space. Is it okay? Do you have any question about this Venn diagram? Any questions? No, clear. Okay. Yes, suppose that a set S, this is sample space, consists of points labeled 1, 2, 3, and 4. We denote this by, yes, S equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. If A is 1 and 2, and B is 2, 3, and 4, and then A and B are subsets of S, denoted by A is a subset of S, and B is a subset of S. In other words, B is contained in S, yes. And we can draw it using a Venn diagram again. A is 1 and 2, B is 2, 3 and 4. So they have only one element in common, it is 2. A is 1 and 2, I am completing the set A. B is 2, 3 and 4. Yes, we denote the fact that 2 is an element of A by 2 is an element of A notation. The union of A and B is 1, 2, 3, and 4, and it is also equal to sample space, as you see. If C equals to 4, yes, We should also draw it in our diagram. Okay. This is C, this is B. What is C? C is only 4, and it is, as you see, also contained by B. So 4, element 4 is the intersection of B and C. So what is only B? Only B is, as you see, 3 here. Yes, this is the final distribution of all elements between A, B, and C. And so what question is, what is A union C? Here, A union C is, as you see, 1, 2, and 4. What is A intersection B? It is 2. What is B intersection C? It is 4. What is, for example, B complement C? What is, for example, A complement C? What is A B complement? What is A union B? Intersection C, for example. Yes, let's answer these questions. Duran, you should attend the courses as much as you can, but if you have problems intersection with other course schedule, you can sometimes attend the other one and this one. Do whatever or how much you can attend is up to you, okay? Yes, one is 23 says, Rula. B complement and C, let's check. B complement. What is B complement? B complement is outside B. Outside B. B complement and C is here. So, yes, it seems as empty. Empty set. Okay. Let's take another color. A complement C. What is A complement? A complement is here. This is A complement. Intersection with C is 4. Yes. A, B complement. What is B complement? Let's take another color. B complement. This is B complement. Intersect with A. It is 1. Yes. A and A union B. A union B is, A union B is this MasterCard, okay? This is A union B. Intersection C. Intersection C is 4, as you see. Yes. Okay, now let's have a break for 10 minutes. Friends. Yes, friends, let's continue. Can you see my screen? Yes. I'm checking if Foxit has a drawing facility here. Polyline, no. No, pencil, yes. Let's try the pencil here. Oh, that's good. Let me take a copy of it. Yes, let's have a look at the distributive laws. A parenthesis B union C means, yes, you will both get the intersection of AB union AC. You will also apply the same rule for the next line. A union B, there is an intersection sign, you know, between B and C. So the equivalent of this equation is A union B intersection A union C. Yes, you know, we don't use intersection sign everywhere. We can abbreviate it like this. And De Morgan's law means how you get the complement of union and also intersection. A union B complement means you will complement everything inside the parenthesis. For example, A complements, and what is the complement of union? It is intersection. And B complement. Similarly, here A B complement means get the complement of everything. First A complement, there's a intersection sign between A and B, and so we also complement it A union B complement. Yes, and use the Venn diagrams to illustrate the distributive laws and De Morgan's law. We can only try one of them, not too much time for it. For example, let's use A and B. For example, let's show what is A union B complement. A union B, you know, inside the MasterCard. Complement of A union B is the outside of it. As you remember, it corresponds to what? Here. It corresponds to A complement B complement. So we validate this as A complement B complement. What is it? A union B complement is A complement B complement, and so on. You can apply it. Let's try also one of them, one of the distributive laws. For example, A intersection B union C. Let's draw A, B, and C. Yes. B union C is, I cannot change the color, I think, can I? Not erase. Not erase. Where is the properties? No. Yes, I am trying what? I am trying this one. Be careful. B union C is this area. And what is the intersection of it with A? Yes. So, what is the area that I have shaded? It is A intersection B union A intersection C, as you see here. And so on. You can prove all the rules with Venn diagrams. And let's continue with the second exercise. Simplify the following. Draw the Venn diagrams to visualize. We don't have to draw, I think, because for all of them. A complement means what? What is the double complement of A? Yes, A itself. Yes. AB union A. Pardon. AB union A. Let's analytically solve it first. What is AB complement? Pardon. What is AB complement? AB complement is A complement union B complement. Yes. Union A. Here you see that you can change the order of them. A complement union A means sample space, simply. So it doesn't make sense of united it with B complement. So the result is sample space. We can also validate it. I am not very comfortable with this environment. I will get a screenshot and go to my... Yes, here I have more control. What we were doing, we were proving it with Venn diagrams. Maybe, but it takes too much screen if you use print screen. Alternatively, Foxit also has a snapshot feature like here. But sometimes I forget it. For example, here, that's okay. And you test it, that's okay. And we were proving this one, A, B. This is AB, you know. AB complement is outside AB. Yes, outside AB. Union A. Union A. What is A? I will unite it with A. So the result is, as you see, A. Okay. No, not A. United with A means, yes, sample space. So why sample space? Because I selected everywhere. AB complement union A, I shaded everywhere, you see, and it is equal to my sample space. Let's continue with the third one. Let's again show it with Venn diagrams first. AB, you see here, union AB complement. Where is AB complement? It is here, you know. AB complement is only A part. If you get the union of them, what does it mean? Union of them means, yes, A. And analytically, AB union AB complement means what? A parenthesis B union B complement. Yes. B union B complement is the sample space. So A intersection sample space is A. Okay. If you get the intersection of A with sample space, you get simply A. Then the fourth one. A union, B union, C. A union, B union, C. All of them. A, B and C union. Intersection B. What is it? What do you think? A union, B union, C. Intersection B. Yes, equals to B. Analytically, it equals to AB union BB union BC. This is B. AB is, you know, the intersection. It is also included in B. BC is intersection. It is also included in C. So if you unite all of them, you also get B. Yes. Is it okay? Do you have any questions about it? Okay, let's continue with the next question. Yes, this is an important question to provide a good understanding on occurring of events at their own or together or at least or exactly and so on. Yes, represent by set notation the following events. Both A and B occur. Do you remember it? What does both A and B occur mean? Both A and B. Intersection or union? And the ISA is union, intersection, union, intersection. Yes, all of you are right, because in a simple approach with our previous learning, both A and B occur may cover everything, but in probabilistic view, it means AB, okay? Both A and B occur means AB. Because here, both of the elements have a part. This is AB, meaning that both A and B occurs. Exactly. One of A and B occurs. Yes, exactly one of them. What does it mean? Which area? Union. Yes, you have many proposals about it. AB complement or BA complement. Yes, union it means. As Cihan says, Muhammad. Yes, Fadil says AB complement. At least one, so union. Yes, most of you are right about it. Yes, at least one. Pardon, exactly one. Exactly one means at the same time only one of them, not two of them together, not both of them together. Exactly one of them. It means, friends, this area and this area, okay? At least, no, exactly one means only A or only B. Yes, it is AB complement union A complement B. Yes. In both shaded areas, only one of the events occur, not two of them occur together. Okay? That is our approach. Is it okay? Do we agree? Okay. And at least it's same color. At least one of them occurs. At least we have A, B, and C. At least means it contains means one of them, two of them, or three of them occurs. Okay? Do you agree? At least one means only one of them? Yes. Two of them together? Yes. Three of them together? Yes. Only one of them is these areas? Yes. Two of them means these areas, and three of them means the center intersection. So, as you see, is equal to A union, B union, C. Yes. And the last one, let's draw it here. At most one of A, B, C occurs. At most one means, what does it mean? One of them or zero of them. Okay, only one of them or none of them. Okay, so we have to draw the sample space. Unfortunately, we have a limited space here. At most one means these areas, one of them, and also none of them. Okay, it is outside the intersections. So I can say that it is what we have very limited space for us. Outside the intersections, what is the intersections? It is AB union BC union AC. This is the intersection part. If you get the complement of it, this is our result. You can also express it with other words, but I think this is the shortest one. Is it okay, friends? Yes.
Okay.
There is also additional information about them here. I pasted it from another book. We are given events A, B if the probability of at least one of A and B happens translates to what? Probability that A union B and at most one of them happens is the complement of the former would be probability A union B complement. At most one of them. No, if the probability of at least one of A and B happens translates to A union B, yes, at most one of them happens. No, it is a question. Sorry, it is a question. So, I forgot it. In what purpose I pasted it here. This is a question. And I think this is the answer or not. The probability at most one of them happens can be broken down into three disjoint cases. It corresponds to the areas we have shaded before, three areas, you see. Probability as a result, A union B complements. No, it is a bit strange. The probability that at most one of A or B happens can be broken into three disjoint cases. Neither A nor B happens. Yes. A but not B happens. Only A. And only B. Yes, this is right. This is correct. Three disjoint cases, neither A nor B happens, none of them, plus A but not B, only A, plus only B. So what are they? None means A union B complement, plus means union, only A is AB complement, only B is A complement B. So it corresponds to the area in fact we had shaded before, but it is not, I think, A union B complement. No, intersection, sorry. Yes, A intersection B complement, yes, it is right. Because A intersection B is the only intersection area, the complement of it is our shaded area. Okay. Yes. Let's clear the book. And this is the last question for today's lecture. The sample space consists of 8 capital letters, outcomes A, B, C to H. Let's draw it. Let V echoes to the event that the letter represents a vowel. Do you know vowel? In Turkish, it is sesli harf. Okay. Vowel letters are A and E, yes. And L is the event that the letter is made of straight lines. L equals to The letter is made of straight lines. Which words are drawn with straight lines? A. B is a bit curvy. C. D has curves. E is straight. F is straight. G is curved. And H is straight. Yes. Describe the outcomes. Yes. A. VL. V intersection L is what? Yes. A and E. Yes. And B. V union L complement. Yes. What is L complement? L complement is curved letters because they are not straight. Complement of straight is curved. B, C, D, and G. Yes. And what is the intersection of these? With what? With V. With V. V, not intersection, pardon, union. We will get the union of these two sets. So it equals to what? A, B, C, D, E, and G. Yes. And C is V complement L complement. That is what we have L complement. Let's also write here V complement. What is V complement? Not vowels. B, C, D, F, G, and H. This is V complement. Intersect it with what? With L complement. So what are common? B are common. C, D, and G. C, D, and G are common. So B, C, D, and G. Yes, I want to continue with two more questions about this because we have time. Let me say D. Yes. Yes, try to solve them. You have 5 minutes or 4 minutes. Scroll up a bit, yes. Yes, I am watching your replies. Can you see all of them? I zoomed out to provide you see all of them. Yes. In fact, the first one, D, I mean D, D is the complement of what? B. Right? D is the complement of B. It is very simple. By the way, as you see, this is the complement of B. I mean this one. So B complement is outside B, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Right, yes, V union L complement, yes, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, right? Yes, D, this is D, yes, Ebru, Rula, İkrim, Muhammed, and so on, yes, all of you are correct, Mehmet, Emre, but, yes, D is okay, but E, results for E are different among you, let's check it. On the other hand, we should shorten this by what getting the complement of it means L, and complement of union is intersection, and complement of V. Yes, L intersection V complement, L intersection V complement is getting the intersection of them. So A, E, F and H, F and H is, yes, the result. And part E, V complement L, V complement L, what is, let's take another color here, V complement L, this is, also I have just found here, V complement L is FH. Okay, this is F and H, V complement L, yes, right, union L complement V, L complement V, intersect them. What is L complement V? Do they have any common elements? No. A, E, B, C, D, G. No, zero. So, yes. The result is, again, F and H. Yes. So, most of you are correct about it. Yes. And that's okay for today. Thanks, friends, for listening this lecture. Yes, maybe. Do you have any questions? Yes, I had just given the PDF. I will also paste it now. This is your PDF. Yes. And what is the other question? Question bank. No, we don't have more. You should check your PDF. And also you can find alternative course books for probability and statistics and increase number of questions to make exercises. Okay. Thank you also for listening. You are also perfect because there was too much attendance to this lecture, much more than previous lectures in this week. So I'm grateful to you to attend the lecture and see you next week.